Hi, I'm Myah Christenson, and welcome to JBCN's segment called Headline News. Here are the top three news stories you need to know to help you stay up to date during your busy school week. To start off, last Sunday, actress Alyssa Milano tweeted, "If all the women who have been sexually harassed or assaulted wrote Me Too as a status, we might give people a sense of the magnitude of the problem. If you've been sexually harassed or assaulted, write Me Too as a reply to this tweet." This movement is meant to raise awareness for sexual assault as people across the globe share their stories and tag their posts with the hashtag. The tweet was in response to the Harvey Weinstein scandal, in which more than 40 women, many of which are famous actresses, have spoken out about the film producer's alleged sexual misconduct. Since then, the tweet has gone viral with more than 1.4 million tweets and counting. Next, as American military encircles Raqqa after months of airstrikes, ISIS continues to fight but is losing control of the Syrian city. The Islamic State has less than 25,000 civilians in what used to be a state of 300,000. For those still trapped in the city, escaping could mean death as ISIS has planted landmines to prevent them from leaving. Although it is impossible to predict, American forces hope for a quick victory of Raqqa while avoiding civilian casualties. In more local news, a Minneapolis-based visual artist, Bobby Rogers, is turning heads with his first solo show called The Black or the Berry, inspired by the Harlem Renaissance and a 2015 song by rapper Kendrick Lamar. This blend of history and hip-hop is seen through the portraits of black models posing in beautiful and sophisticated attire as royalty. Rogers says he wanted to show not the suffering of the black people, but the excellence. That's it for this week. Join us next week for more headline news. This is Myah Christenson reporting for Johnnie, Bennie Campus News.